I was so emotionally into it when I was writing it, but then you play like hundreds of shows and then it's all just songs suddenly. So it's just I feel very emotionally disconnected from it now because of that. You play overplay stuff, you know, and then I kind of hadn't analyzed that album in a really long time. There are a few songs there that I'm still super happy with,
yeah,
you know,
too.
that we're actually playing on every single show that I'm like Bonneville,
yeah,
for
Bonneville,
example.
It's still a very strong album, I think. And a few times some friends or whatever just put on something randomly in the car or on Spotify. It's like, yeah, very proud of this.
Yeah.
I think we did definitely the best we could at that time, and we were aiming for a way more organic sound than before, and maybe more than this one as well, and we nailed it. So I'm super proud of Malina.
I mean, regarding the sound on Malina, uh-huh. like the more organic approach that we aimed at that, I feel like we've been developing that same thing, even though we have a lot of like synthetic instruments as well on this new album. I still feel it's a very organic sound because a lot of things has been made in the studio, played live. So we have like
absolutely
more strings, like the choir.
Absolutely, but it's kind of more like mix it into sometimes being super strict and electronic sounding, and then kind of sometimes even in the same song just floating out and becoming really, really open and acoustic. So it's to have kind of contrasts, you know.
Yeah. It gives a lot of space for the electronic elements to when they like occur. Then it's like really a cool effect.
And I think if I were living a little bit more mentally in 2019 and not hanging so much back, maybe it would have been even more electronic elements as well, drum wise. I think it was kind of planned to have way more electronic elements for the drums, but because I suck at that and I aim for the acoustic all the time, I kind of fighted through.
It was a little bit like I had programmed lots of loops or put lots of loops there, and then we're just like, just go ahead and do your thing, and then we see if it becomes better than the loops, then we keep it, and then we just ended up with mostly acoustic drums. So
been touring a lot with Malina, from the it's been a lot of peaks.
Most intense touring ever in Leprous.
It's been so many tours, and I'm really appreciative that we've actually been given the chance to do it, because it's not something that's given that you can do.
No, the good thing is that on this album cycle we started rotating a lot between like our whole catalog almost, like, so we're having like 36 or something songs in rotation. So the set list is different every night, so that kind of was, we were able to kind of keep, if we grew tired of a song, then we just didn't play it for a few shows, and then
that's
going
to be even better for them.
We put it back in the set list, and again it was like, oh, now it's cool again, you
definitely.
Know, now it's nice. But like, if there is like one highlight or not, I'm not sure, because it's been so many great things happening in that period, like for the band, and lots of great shows. I remember like a few, so like the Latin American tour was amazing, of course, because it's our first time there. It's a very passionate crowd, very appreciative. So that was, of course, an experience.
Yeah. I would say it's starting to sell out a lot of shows. That's actually
We never sold out anything before the Malina cycle.
Yeah.
And then suddenly, started selling out shows. And, well,
yeah,
that's cool.
So that's
how that feels.
Yeah. All right.